Hello all. Today let us see log file monitoring with a regular expression. Log file monitoring is quite simple, but there is a few challenges with respect to regex or regular expression. So let us start by creating an application name for it called log underscore monitor. Once this is created by clicking on this create application and then giving it a name here, we're going to associate this with the items. So going to the items, we've already created the item and tested it. So let us click on create item and I'm going to show you how it is done. So I'm going to give it a name like log monitoring with regex, or a particular name of the application or the regular expression can also be given for our understanding. Then we give the Zabbix agent active as the type here, which is most important for the log file monitoring. The next important thing is the key. Here we are using log as the key, and inside that we are going to give the path of the log file and then the regular expression. So as you can see, there are two regular expressions separated by a pipe. So the meaning of this is that if one of the expression, regular expression, is found, it is going to throw the error, and if the second regular expression is found, then it is going to recover the error. So basically it is an error and the OK statement in a log file monitoring, because if we don't do it in this way, then the log file will never be able to go out of the active browser in the problems page. So this is a very good arrangement to say. The most important next one is the type of information to be as log only and not any other option. Update interval, I need to keep it to the interval when the files get updated with these error codes. Should not be 1 minute or need not be 1 minute all the time. So if it is 1 hour or once in a day it's going to write, we have to just put it a few minutes after that. So ideally 10 minutes or 5 minutes should be good enough if it is not very critical. And coming down into the application section, we are going to select the application that we had created earlier. So once this is done, we're going to go to the triggers and we're going to click on create triggers here from the top corner, and then let's get inside. So here we can give a meaningful name, and then we will be selecting the problem from here, and I'll just show you what I have done. I have basically said this is the regular expression part dot reg exp. So here what happens is that whenever there is an issue, it is going to trigger an error for this particular part, and then with the recovery option, it is going to fix it for this particular part. Let us try and deploy this regular expression. So there is already log that I have created. So let me just execute this. I just copy the error message and then I do an echo of the message to my log.log in the temp. So now that I have added that, let's go to the problems page. Then wait. Yes, we can see log monitoring issue on my log has been triggered. Now let us go to our notepad and copy the regular expression for the OK message, and then let me echo the same to my log.log and execute it. So with this, it should resolve this particular alert. So let's wait for the problem to get resolved. For the ease of understanding, I'm executing immediately. In real scenario, the problem and the resolution may not be coming back to back within a minute or two. The problem may occur at a different time and the resolution may occur at a different time, but it's okay. So as soon as the problem statement is seen, it is going to trigger the problem, and whenever there is a resolution code is seen, it's going to resolve the alert. So as we can see, the problem has been resolved. So let us take another example to test it out. So echo, oops, mylog.log, and let us wait for the next alert. It's gonna trigger another alert. In the meanwhile, let's just be prepared for this. So it also doesn't mean that the first one has a resolution as the first message here, or the second one with the second one. It can be anything as long as it satisfies the regular expression. So these things can vary. It's a regular expression. So here it doesn't mean that for the 249 problem, 105 is the solution, or 253, 12 is the solution, nothing like that. So as you can see, the problem has been triggered, and now let us do another echo of this to mylog.log, and let's wait for this alert also to get resolved. Yep, as we can see, the problem has also been resolved. That's it, guys. More in the next. Thank you.